And it is time for the first federal program, Patriots Day today, so we figured we'd kick the show off with God Bless the USA.
Kind of gives you the chills.
It does.
Yeah, I think that song seems to get more meaningful every year. I remember having to sing that in elementary school performances for your parents and stuff, and really great to hear that this morning.
Yes, I figured. I talked with Tanner last night, and we decided that we would do this. That way, we showed our support.
That's great. So 19 years ago, plane hits one of the towers, another plane hits the other tower, another plane goes crazy into a field in Pennsylvania. Where were you then?
I was in junior high school. I was the office helper. So I got to help do things around the office. And I had all my homework done for the day. And so it was originally my study hall, so I was in there helping. And since there was nothing to do in the office or for me to do, the principal at the time said, well, you can come watch the news in my office.
Wow.
And he turned it on, and I sat down, and I was watching it, and then it happened, and I went out to him, and I said, you may want to come see this. And so, yeah, he went into friendship mode after that.
One of those things in our lifetime that you remember what you were doing on that day. I remember some of our teachers talking about when JFK was shot in their lifetime when they were younger, and this is it for me. I don't know. What about you, Tanner?
I was in fourth grade and went to Terrell's class, and I remember we came back from, I don't know, from the gym or what it was, and she had a concerned look on her face. She kind of set us down and explained what was going on. Of course, we're in fourth grade. We don't really understand what's going on, and we never did get to see it on TV. They never, at least our class, she never put it on TV.
Yeah.
So I didn't really understand what was going on until I got home after school that day. And even then, I don't think it really hit me for another week or so what was exactly going on. But it's something I'll never forget.
Well, we've never experienced that kind of pause in our normal life, you know, up to that point.
Yeah.
It did stop a lot of things for quite a while. I can kind of remember the, let's see, it would have been baseball playoff time when getting close to that. Mm-hmm. I just remember, I think the president threw out the first pitch at some point in one of the games in New York City, and they finally got
Yankees
things,
and the Diamondbacks. Yep.
Finally got things going again. Just some really neat moments. But yeah, we want to salute our active troops and our veterans too today for defending America. And you know, the phrase that we're supposed to keep in mind, which is kind of apropos, never forget that day. So I'm proud to carry that tradition on and take a moment to talk about that. Okay. Hey, finally getting some good camping weather.
Yeah,
finally.
You can actually be in a sleeping bag overnight now, I think, if it gets down into the 50s or 60s. So. Yeah, I don't know if my family's listening, but we may want to go camping this weekend. So, glad that different weather's here. A little bit less hot and maybe a little less humid. We'll see.
Yeah, get away with the humidity. I'm all for that.
That would be nice. Hey, we got an esteemed guest this morning, waiting in the wings. Jodi Wynn from First Federal Savings Bank is going to be joining us later. She's our Vice President of Deposits. And been with the bank longer than I have, so she may have some history for us. I don't know. Worked with Jodi the whole time I've been there, and really enjoy it. So we're going to be speaking with her about the deposit side of the bank this time, and some of the services that we offer there, and some of the consumer service that we provide. You know, some of those things have been changing over the years, and been a fun challenge for banks like community banks like us to continue discovering different technologies that we can offer that consumers are interested in as their preferences change. So we'll talk a little bit about that and some other things. Our trivia this morning, and Paul, I saw you got stumped.
I did.
So this one's over. I feel a lot of pressure released this
morning. Yep, me too.
Unless I get it right.
Start a new streak.
Yeah, we've got 20 minutes yet for you to be with the streak broken at least. What year did the National September 11th Memorial and Museum open to the public in New York City? Was it 2007, 2015 or 2011.
Okay.
And I, Emily and I actually got the chance to go visit there a couple, maybe two or three years ago. And I really didn't know much about it before we went. You actually go down, like below ground, and where the towers structurally were set for this museum. It was really a powerful place to visit. I knew I wanted to go, but I didn't really know how badly I should want to go. It's a neat place.
I went to the memorial 2 years ago, but not the museum part. And but even walking around the memorial is really neat, but also kind of just get the chills being there. It's just a weird, odd feeling. You can't really describe it unless you go to it.
It was one of the quietest places I've been.
Absolutely.
Which was really interesting. A lot of reverence, I think, and awe for really, truly what happened there.
And I don't know if you did this, but when I was standing there, I was kind of trying to envision and put myself back in time on that day, just looking around at the surroundings and everything and try to...
Yeah, where would I be running towards or from, you know, and it also you kind of challenge yourself inside, like, would I have been brave enough to help someone and run into danger like a lot of the servicemen did, men and women did that day. Just really interesting information that you get there. So, okay, figure out what year that was, Paul, or don't. All right, Tanner, sports.
Yeah.
Alive and well.
It's exciting to, you know, come in and every week, hey, I got some games to report to you for some games to preview.
You were almost going to get fired for the lack of information you're providing.
I understand that. So glad I came through. But Rutgers Zebras now have a game under their belts. Fortunately, they lost to Waco last week, but they get a chance to bounce back tonight as they'll have their first road contest of the season. They're going to be traveling to Manchester, who has a 1-2 record. I read last night, I believe, I'll credit Val on this one, that Rochester has not won at Manchester since 2014. So, they're due.
Streak.
They're due. Manchester's got a brand new field they're playing on over there, I believe. I think Manchester College got a brand new field. If they're still playing their games at Manchester College, Manchester University.
Is it field turf or is it
turf,
grass?
Yeah.
Okay.
Manchester University.
Nice.
So it used to be Manchester College.
Yeah. They changed that.
What time's it? Yeah. What time's pregame tonight?
6:30.
All right. Tune into that.
Oh, yeah.
That's Tippecanoe Valley's got a 1-2 record. They're traveling to North Miami tonight, who's also got a 1-2 record. Winnemac got off to a solid start for their season last week when they defeated North White. They're 1-0. They host LaVille tonight, who's making their debut for the season. LaVille has yet to play a game. So, they're record of 0-0. And Caston's coming off a tough loss last week to Triton. They're 1-2. They're traveling to Pioneer, who is 2-0 and one of the best.
Ooh, they're good again.
One of the best teams in the state. Yeah, they
again. I don't think Pioneer's had an off year in a long time.
Last year wasn't quite Pioneer standards, at least as far as record. But they're loaded again this year, so they're back. So, but good luck to all those teams involved tonight.
Let's go Comets.
Yes. The NFL season kicked off last night, so the Chiefs beat the Texans 34-20. I watched a little bit of it, didn't watch a ton of it, but it was nice to see live professional football back on, but yet, like we were talking, Evan, earlier this morning, it was kind of felt like you're watching a preseason game as far as the atmosphere. Just with the lack of crowd, it was just different. I mean, it's going to take some time to get used to.
Kind of like still watching baseball.
Yeah. It's just going to take time to get used to, and maybe... And you don't get used to it.
I don't really have opinions. I just don't find myself as interested.
Yeah.
I don't know why. I'm trying.
There's no fans hype and everything.
Yeah, I'm excited it's back.
Yeah. But your Bears are in action on Sunday as they travel to Detroit.
Hey, they're usually good against the Lions. Well, that can be said about every NFL team. But 35 years since the Super Bowl shuffle. The same.
Yeah.
This could be it.
Could be it.
The Trubisky-led Bears.
They decide on Trubisky over Foles. Now it's time to go.
So. They should have a great defense again.
The Lions are 3-point favorites, but I did pick the Bears. I picked the Bears in my picks this week. So.
Okay, thanks.
And the Colts are 7.5-point favorites. They're on the road to Jacksonville this week. Assume that's going to be on.
Starting at noon.
Starting at noon on Sunday. Jacksonville's picked by a lot of experts to be the worst team in the league, so
good.
Colts should have a good chance to get off to a good start.
They seem to have been offloading decent players here lately.
I think they're trying to kind of tank and get that number one pick for Trevor Lawrence next year. That's just my opinion. I could be wrong.
Well, hey, you know what? As long as they're worse than the Browns this year, I'm happy.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Your wish will probably come true.
And Notre Dame fans will be happy as the Irish kick off their season tomorrow with their host in Duke. Notre Dame's ranked 10th this year in the polls, and they're 20-point favorites tomorrow.
Who would you who would you pick on that game with the 20 points?
And that's a good question because I don't know much about Duke at all coming into the year. I'd say Notre Dame's probably the safe bet there.
Think they'll cover up?
Okay. Yeah, I think they'll be pretty good this year. And I was asked by somebody the other day, who's going to be my college football team this year without Purdue playing? And I said, whoever's playing Notre Dame every week.
Oh,
been
ouch.
Well, just being honest.
Got unfollowed by a couple people.
Oh, yes. Never fails. I got some tidbits here this morning.
Wait, I wanted to tell Chip, the Cubs won last night, by the way.
There you go. Beat the Reds.
Yeah, and they're ahead of the Cardinals by 3 games.
Still a little cushion there.
A little.
I know Mark Blueball of our financial services department, he's a big Cardinal fan. So
yes, he is.
He's hoping they can keep the pressure on the Cubs.
They have to play a lot of games, so I don't know where they're going to find the pitching arms to
in
such a short amount of time.
It'll be interesting to keep an eye on that. Got some tidbits here this morning. On this day in 1875, the first newspaper cartoon strip was published. It was Professor Tig Whistle's Burglar Alarm in the New York Daily. Never heard of it.
Why don't you show a clip of that for the camera? You have one with you?
I wish. I
should. Oh, Tanner, what a great opportunity.
I'd look it up, but I probably, you know, if I got it right, then I'd be accused of cheating.
On this day in 1936, FDR dedicated the Boulder Dam, which is now known as the Hoover Dam.
I didn't know that.
I didn't know that either.
I didn't learn that, I guess.
On this day in 1970, the Ford Pinto was introduced. And on this day in 1977, the Atari 2600 was released in North America. It kind of revolutionized the gaming industry, really, for North America and the U.S.
Maybe it's kind of the origin, maybe.
Yeah.
Most people have a gaming system at home rather than going to an arcade.
And lastly, on this day in 1985, Pete Rose got his 4,190-second career hit off Eric Show of the San Diego Padres, eclipsing Ty Cobb's record.
Wow.
And Pete Rose still has that hits record. I think that will be one record that stands the test of time.
Yeah.
And he's still on the Hall of Fame. For right or wrong, you could argue that. But still not all that. Maybe something.
I don't see how someone can get that many hits.
That's incredible. He's quite a player.
Yeah.
And today is National Make Your Bed Day. Also National No News is Good News Day. Patriot Day, as we covered at the start of the show. And Hot Cross Bun Day.
Okay.
So you've seen those buns that have like the white shape on top that look like a cross? That's what they're talking about.
Okay.
So it doesn't reference the nursery rhyme school or song?
Not the description on there, but yeah.
Oh, okay.
You know that one?
I do.
All right.
No. I'll work on it for next week.
Yep. Preparation.
Thank you, Tanner.
You're welcome.
I'm not a good singer myself.
Yeah.
Mrs. Shelley, Tanner and I were just talking. Mrs. Shelley asked me at one time to try out for Manitas, and I said, "Oh, you must have never heard me sing in church. I'm horrible." Well, that obviously didn't happen. Okay, upcoming events. Akron Lions Club's having a fish fry tomorrow at the Akron Community Center from 4 until sold out. Cost is $9 a pound. Curbside pickup only. And Rochester Wrestling Club's having a 5th annual golf tournament. It's coming up Saturday, September 19th. Registration's at 8:30 a.m. Shotgun start at 9. They'll have some lunch afterwards and some awards. It's $60 a person or $240 for a team. Junior Achievement for Fulton County is hosting a fall fashion show and fundraiser also on September 19th, Saturday. It'll be 6 to 7 p.m. at the Fulton County Community Center. Tickets are $50 a person, or a table of eight can be reserved for $350. There's additional sponsorship opportunities if you are interested, from $100 to $500. And this morning we wanted to recognize my family friends Ben and Janine Crispin for their 60th wedding anniversary, which happened on September 2nd. Congratulations, Ben and Janine.
You gonna make it to 60 years?
Absolutely.
That's the attitude.
15 this year.
Hey.
So.
I'll be 9 this year. So.
Okay. It can be done.
Yeah.
So great folks like that showing us the way, Paul.
Absolutely.
The Dow Jones, you've been following the stock market much this week?
Yes.
It's been up and down, whipsaw.
Yeah.
It's down 390 points this week, the Dow Jones is. September, the whole month's really been really wild so far.
So far.
But the tech stocks are showing a lot of volatility, and they've been kind of had some high values for a while. So a lot of pandemic momentum behind them, and is that going to continue or not? I think that's a big question. Also notice that JCPenney is in the news again. They've been in the news a lot the last few years. They were purchased by mall owners Simon and Brookfield out of bankruptcy in an $800 million deal to keep some of those stores open in the malls. So if you need some clothes or cooking ware, that would be a good place to go. Amazon's having a big job fair. This was interesting.
Yes.
September 16th, they'll have, it's not 1,000 jobs, there's 1,000 recruiters from Amazon looking to place 33,000 jobs. They're going to spend the day sitting down with 20,000 people to do some career coaching.
Yeah,
so
that's a lot.
All those at minimum wage of $15 an hour. Oof. So, interesting strategy. Yeah. That is a massive company. Yeah. And then I noticed the Citigroup, big bank, East Coast Wall Street Bank, is making Jane Fraser the first woman to become CEO of a Wall Street bank.
Oh,
that's
cool.
A big milestone. So, we normally talk about First Federal before our guest, but let's go ahead and have Jodi Wynn come on in. Right now she is First Federal on this show for us. Welcome, Jodi.
Good morning, thank you.
Hey, we mentioned earlier you're the Vice President of Deposits for us. At the bank, what on earth does that mean?
We don't know someday.
It's whatever we throw at you.
It is whatever you throw at me. I spend my day making sure that the deposit side runs smoothly. So all the checking accounts and savings accounts and everything that goes with your accounts is working the way it should.
That sounds like daily moving of money that we all care a lot about.
It is.
Who has a checking or savings account there? That's a big job. So talk to us a little bit about the deposit side of the bank. Over the years, I know we've been focusing on adding different services that complement changes in our consumer preferences.
Yeah.
Give us a little bit of an idea of some of the things that have come around since the iPhone came out and since some of these things.
Well, you think about the deposit side, you know about checking accounts and savings accounts and CDs, and that's really the building blocks of everything. What we have to take from there is all those other things that you want, because gone are the days where you only wanted to come into the bank.
That's true.
And figure out what your balance was. When I started, you know, as a teller many years ago, the only way you knew what your balance was is to come to the bank and ask the teller. So now, you know, we've got that in your fingertips with the smartphone, your Android, and your iPhones. We've come up with apps where you can get your balance real time. You can take pictures of checks in the app. You can get alerts that tells you that this check is cleared or your balance is at this point, or, you know, you change your email address even. So all that at your fingertips, it makes it so much easier.
It seems like back in the day, you know, maybe it was because it was the only option, but you needed to ask someone to tell you something.
Mm-hmm.
Well, now I think a big change is just self-service.
Absolutely.
I'm used to finding something out myself. And maybe that's from, you know, 25 years of being able to go to a search engine and find something online. You know, we've been trained now to, I'm going to just find this out myself.
And
I don't
definitely
want to
have
to
that
ask.
Ability now. No, we're still there. You can still come and ask us. You know, don't get me wrong. We're happy to have you come in and we'll talk to you about it. But it gives you a little bit more power.
You mentioned mobile deposit. Well, actually, you said take pictures of checks.
Yes.
Tell us just a bit about that and what that does for someone. What's the value there?
You know, so many of us get our paychecks direct deposit, but you get an occasional check. You know, someone's going to write you a check for your birthday or something. and maybe you don't know when to come to the bank, or that's not on your normal path. Well, you can go right into our smartphone app, you can sign the check, and then from there you can take a picture of the front and the back, and it'll get sent to us, and we'll get that in your account the next day. So it's a really quick way for those one-off checks. Some people use it for their paychecks too, but you can get that done right away without stopping the bank if you don't want to.
I think one thing that speaks to too is just, you know, we're used to business hours also for banks, and there's an old joke about banking hours out there. I don't think that exists anymore.
I don't think so.
Okay. But you can actually deposit that check when it's convenient time-wise for you. Like for me, that would be at like 9 p.m. after all the kids are in bed. Now I can think about making my deposit or something like that.
That app and all the things that go with it make it so it's accessible 24 hours a day. The ATM started to do that for us when those were introduced, and now we've taken the next step where those online services are available whenever you need them.
Okay, another self-service item that we've added in the last couple of years, I know you were a big part of this, was something called Card Valet.
It's one of my favorite things that we've done at the bank. And I don't think people use it enough, but it's the best and first line of prevention against fraud on your account. I think a lot of people have experienced where they look at their bank statement, or they look online, and they say, well, I didn't do that debit card transaction, and it can spiral really, really quickly. Because we remember the data breaches with Target, and we've had some with like maybe Wendy's or Applebee's or something.
That's right.
And you hear about those where these fraudsters are getting these debit card numbers from different company servers, and what they're doing is just making cards and trying to see who's not paying attention to their account so they can access that money. And so with Card Valet, what it does is it gives you an alert every time your card is used somewhere. It sounds like, oh, well, that would be annoying, right?
Maybe.
Like, well, I don't want an alert all the time. But how often do you really use your card in a day? And you know you're doing it. You swipe your card and you get an alert real time within seconds. If you didn't do that transaction, and you know, if Evan got an alert right now, he's not using his card. So it could alert him, oh, you know what, that's maybe not right. And then what you can do beyond that is go in and shut your card off. So it'll make it so no transactions can go through until you can get to the bank and we can figure out exactly what's been going on with it. It allows you to reduce your spending limits. You know, we have a limit in place. We'll let you spend, you know, up to $4,000 a day, provided you have that much in your account, on your card. But say you don't want to do that, you can put your spending limits down lower. You can restrict where you spend your card at. It's great if you've got teenagers, maybe, that you're trying to control their account a little bit more. So it's really one of my favorite things. And you can just download it from the App Store, both Android and Apple, and get it set up in just in minutes.
That's great. Thank you for working on that. We've had a lot of people adopt that. Is there a charge to that, Jodi?
No, absolutely not.
That's incredible. Free, like all these other things, right?
Oh, yeah, I love free.
All these online services are free.
That's crazy. We are speaking with Jodi Wynn, our Vice President of Deposits at First Federal Savings Bank. She's talking to us a little bit about some of the services that we offer on the deposit side. Jodi, has this year the pandemic affected kind of some of these services we do? I know, you know, we didn't have our lobbies open for several weeks, a couple of months, and we were doing things through the drive-up. What's that done to with some of these services that we're talking about?
I think it's had people try them out that they never maybe would have tried them before. And so we've been able to help a lot of customers learn about these new services and give them a try and get them a little bit more comfortable with it. Because they're great services, and we want everyone to use them.
Kind of giving someone over the hump
of saying, hey, to do that, for sure.
You know, some things like this, they have to add value to your life, and maybe in the past they didn't.
Right.
But when things are shut down and maybe you don't want to go out, or you know, we weren't having anyone come inside, you
right.
could wait in the drive-up.
You know, some people love to come in the bank, and we love to have them there, but then they got a little nervous and didn't want to come in. And we totally respect that. This gave them the option to have that information without coming in.
A couple other things we've added the last couple of years. One is, you know, obviously we make a lot of home loans. We've added the ability to have mobile or online payments mm-hmm. of those home loans, the monthly payment. You can do that on demand or mm-hmm. schedule.
Absolutely. Just go to the website and you can have an account with us or without us. We prefer it to be with us, of course, but if you don't have it with us, you can still make it online without filling that check-in.
A lot of people aren't writing checks.
They aren't.
To that point. Now, what if I owed you some money right now?
Well, we've got another fun thing on our app called Zelle, which is a person-to-person payment system, where as long as you know somebody's cell phone number or the email address, you can send them money through our app, and they'll get it in real time.
So maybe if Paul and I had a $5 bet on this trivia question,
yeah,
he could pay me. just my cell phone number, which I could write down on this sheet of paper here
right.
for him after
right.
the show's over.
And we can make that happen here in a little bit.
Oh.
I'll step you right through it, Paul.
Okay, good, because I got a feeling I know the answer.
Oh, no, that's not good. I shouldn't have opened my mouth. Well, it's fun learning about things that can kind of take some of the anxiety out of using these things. Card Valet takes a little anxiety about using your debit card. Gives you some power in your hand. Talk to us a little bit about community banking. You know, how are we similar to national banks? Because a bank like us, you know, we started in a community like this. We're a size that's very relevant for our community,
for sure.
And we're in touch. But how are we similar to some of the national banks?
Well, I think when you look at the national banks, you think they've got all these services. We have all the exact same services that they have. There's very little that they can do that we can't do. And actually, I think we can do it better because I know you, Paul, and you can call me if you're having trouble with that, and you're going to get me on the phone. And so we've got all the same services. We've got the Zelda nationwide network. I mean, that's almost every bank in the country participates in that. Having you know, the apps and all those things, we have just like the big national banks do. But we can do it with a personal touch, which I think makes a big difference.
We've also got a lot of demo videos that Tanner's helped put on our website. If you're interested in any of these services that Jodi's mentioned this morning, it's very likely we've got a demonstration video on our website, www.firstfederalbanking.com.
And those videos are great. They're step-by-step, branded for us. Tanner does a great job getting them up there.
So if you're listening, you've maybe known we've had some of these things or you didn't, but maybe you think now's a good time to check it out. Maybe start with the video, give myself, Jodi, Tanner a call. We can help you or talk to your new accounts tellers are good ways to do that.
Lots of people at the bank can help you with any of those services.
Yeah, and we have an email address too, online at firstfederalbanking.com. It's really for any general questions you may ever have. Send that in and we're very responsive to you. Any other parting words of wisdom, Jodi?
Just come out and see us at First Federal and open a new account with us.
We're actually open now.
Come on in. Come see us. We've got great checking accounts for you. Then we can get that started. And then get all these other packages chopped up and running for you same day.
And these are for your convenience, but it doesn't mean we don't want to see you.
Right.
We want
you
coming
to
in.
You.
We enjoy our relationships with you.
Check out what kind of masks you've got.
I like yours this morning,
by
the way.
Ready to coordinate.
Thank you so much, Jodi, for joining us.
Absolutely.
And giving us some helpful hints on some things that we've got available at the bank. Okay, we'll give you a shot at this trivia answer as well. What year did the National September 11th Memorial and Museum open to the public?
Am I guessing first?
07, 11, or 15? We'll let Paul guess first.
11.
Okay.
What was my guess?
You're correct. It actually opened on September 11th, 2011.
I was going to say, I was thinking that it opened in remembrance of the 10th anniversary.
I think they've done a lot of things really well in regards to making sure this is in the forefront of our minds and what it all means. So
do we show you how to use all
this? Yeah. Unfortunately, I already know how to, and now I'm going to have to tape all.
No.
Okay, let's think about these words of wisdom as we close today. This is from Walt Disney. You ever heard of him?
I have.
Okay. All our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them.
I like it.
Hey, thanks everybody for joining us this morning. Thanks, Paul, for hosting us.
And we're going to close with another song about America.
Awesome.
In remembrance of patriots.
Have a great weekend, everyone.
Thanks. You too, guys.